Don't expect good gameplay in this video because I have literally no idea what I'm doing. Okay, so the circle. Also, I'm chewing gum and I'm so sorry. So the circle, the movie review, the one I'm here to do. Right off the bat, it's horrifying. I feel like this movie is going to have two separate reactions. Because the movie is kind of made and crafted in this way of being very subtle. The entire movie is extremely subtle. Almost subtle to the point that if you're not paying careful attention to the themes it's trying to get across, I can understand why you'd call it boring. And honestly, I don't feel like that's an accurate portrayal of what the movie is at all. Because I was watching it and I was scared. I was greatly scared. The goal of the movie really isn't accurate. It's more of a debate on a question. At what point, and the question pretty much boils down to this, at what point is your privacy sold? At what point, in the name of science and technology, is your privacy up for sale? What would it take to kind of give up that privacy? And being told through the outsider's eyes in this giant technological company with Emma Watson, you get to see how she's kind of shady and shifty at the first idea of what's happening. Then she kind of gets used to everything. And she kind of just starts accepting things that these are the norm. This is what is normal and okay. And it very much follows this idea of almost indoctrination of, hey, this is okay. What's happening is normal. You don't need the outside. You don't need your privacy. Your privacy is unwanted. And he's kind of just like, obviously it's way more subtle than that. And it's something that just, I think, needs to be taken account of. Each of the characters kind of represent something. Some are really obvious and some just aren't. I'll go over the really obvious ones first. And that is, I'm sorry that I forgot his name, but that's kind of fitting as to what he represents. Patton Oswalt's character represents the hidden man. The man that, he's not on screen a lot of the time, and the time he is, it's important to note when he's on screen. He's very much the person who's kind of just pushing ideas along and kind of getting to what the truth is behind the company. He very much represents the true intentions of the company. Then you have Tom Hanks' character, which very much represents the show, the flashiness, the all the good that's happening, why the justification for everything that's happening. And he's very much the distraction, is his representation. You have Mercer, who represents privacy. He is a very clear representation of privacy and what that means in the film. And it's interesting to see how his story arc will progress because of his representation. And I'm not going to spoil his ending or any of the characters' ending here or now. I'll wait until the end of the video to do that. But he does represent privacy. Emma Watson's character of May represents the common consumer, the common man. And I'm not really sure what Anne represents. Haven't really thought about her. If anything, I'd say she represents the eagerness of the general public. The, oh God, I hope this is true, of the general public. And she's very interesting to watch if you consider her in that perspective. But the movie isn't a movie, like I've said. It's more of a discussion. And the movie is very subtle with its things, as I've also said. a lot of, like, I think Patton Oswalt described it best when he was in an interview with Jimmy Fallon of, it's a movie, it is a horror movie. It is a horror movie in the way that you don't expect it to be a horror movie. It's a movie that distracts you and blinds you until the very end when you realize, I am terrified. And that's very much, I feel, the movie, why the movie was made and the perspective it was made for. However, I do, there's a very different way of seeing this movie. There's a way of seeing this movie that is the way of, it's just about corruption and power corruption and not what it's really about, which is, again, privacy. I can very much see how both of these kind of takeaways are taken away and not the deeper meanings of privacy and the extent of you don't realize you're screwed until it's much too late, and that whole part of the privacy movie and the discussion. Because the movie does something else that I thought was really smart. It talks about how mistakes when it comes to this field are easily covered up. Not seeing the truth is very easy for the leaders of this company. It's very easy to get away scot-free in this business. And that was something really interesting. The movie kind of starts out with Emma Watson's character, May, of being very downtrodden. She kind of hates her life. She hates the direction it's going. And she's caught up in debt. She's really just altogether screwed as a character. And she is inherently going to be doomed. One way or another, she is, for lack of a better term, doomed. And then she gets this job at the Circle, this tech conglomerate company, and one by one, her problems kind of just start fading away as she gives more and more of her privacy away. And there's this really interesting idea. And because she does try to get, she doesn't get a lot of warning. She kind of just, she's very much the character of, no, this is good. Like, I can see why this is happening. This is a good thing. We can use this for good. And she's very much this character who tries to just push forward the positives of using all this tech. The parts that we would in our society use it for. And everything that comes out of her mouth is very good of heart. It's very pure. And it goes so far to say that one of the other characters in the movie, which I'm not going to tell you his name or what he does, because that's a spoiler, he even says this. He goes, I knew I could trust you because you don't have a cynic bone in your body. And it very much captures this idea of, not only are you the good guy, you are almost naive in how good you are. And that's something that other people can use. And I thought that was a really interesting idea and concept to kind of be pushed forth. So I really enjoyed that idea. But the movie, I can't really talk much more about the movie without spoiling it. So this is your spoiler warning. If you still want to see this movie, if you want to see how everything kind of goes down and is discussed, leave now. I highly suggest you go check this movie out, and just, you see what it's about. I really do recommend you see this movie and just have a conversation. Have a conversation with the people around you and the people you think would want to see something like this, or the people you think that wouldn't want to see something like this. Heck, even show it to someone you think that the idea of what this movie is talking about would go over their heads, because those are the kind of people that really need to see this movie. Those are the people that need this movie. Now that I've given you a spoiler alert and all that's dandy, I'm gonna start talking about spoilers. So, the climax of the movie comes at this point where, thanks to everything Emma Watson's character, May, has given up in the name of the greater good and for technological advancement and society's embetterment, she ends up leading this manhunt for her friend. Her friend that she's been ignoring for a long time, and just this friend that she hasn't seen in months. She ends up starting this manhunt for, and it's almost Shakespearean how this character's downfall is something of itself. It's something that couldn't have come from the outside. It was because of who this character is fundamentally that he was always going to fail. And of course I'm talking about Mercer. His representation of privacy and needing to have something for himself and needing to be disconnected from everything is ultimately his downfall. Because in a society that has been combed by this idea of technology being whole, that is what ends Mercer's life. He gets driven off of a cliff, and we see how the circle immediately turns it around for a PL move. They say, this should have never happened. This horrendous accident that by all rights they caused. They caused this accident 100%, and no one can really deny that. Was a horrible accident. We were act to prevent it from here on out. We were act to stop horrendous acts like this from happening again. Also, this has nothing to do with the movie, but I just realized what we were actually playing on, and that's kind of funny. But his death kind of starts the whole climax of the movie, and it talks about how he will be the voice of the generation that causes people to stand up. He will be the reason people stand, and they will start to fight for their freedom again. They will start to fight for their privacy again. He is the reason. His voice is the voice of a martyr. And this is kind of where you kind of see where the shallow ending of this movie comes out. Where you find out that the CEO of the company has obviously been lying. And he hasn't been transparent. Which is something that was really interesting because I hadn't noticed at all how he wasn't being transparent. It was just really interesting how it kind of took this moment for me to be like, oh, wait a minute. This giant bloody hypocrite has been playing by his own rules. And it was interesting to really have that realization of, oh crap. And I loved it. I loved having that moment of realization. Well, I just was like, oh damn. Because even though I thought I was paying attention, I wasn't paying attention enough to catch it. I wasn't paying attention enough. So just as much as people in the movie weren't paying attention, I also wasn't paying attention. And I was like, damn. And it really just caught me off guard, and I loved that moment. I loved having that moment. But the movie ends really suddenly with a conference meeting of, this is wrong, this is unbelievable what's happening. That's such a bad score, by the way. This is unbelievable what's happening. We have leaked all of your documents. We leaked everything that you have that you can hide behind. We've leaked it all and it's all out there, and now you will be transparent. And it was this moment of, oh, damn. And Emma Watson starts going into this monologue where she's like, and we would take back this company. It would be the company that we started and the company we believed in. And then she walks out a door and the door slams behind her and it goes to black. Now, this isn't the first time the movie has done a sudden to black. So I'm expecting more. I'm expecting another scene of like an epilogue type thing where they kind of talk about all the changes that were made and how, like, what the email is actually said and all this and that. And you never get it. You never see any of it. And I'm walking away from the theater and I'm thinking one of two things. I'm like, okay, either A, this was a setup for a sequel. I think it's a poorly idea sequel. It's a poorly founded sequel. I don't think it's going to actually become a sequel. But it's an attempt at leaving a cliffhanger for a sequel to see where, when put in the right hands, what technology can actually do after having all this time of fear and all this other crap. You can see where it could go. And then I had the thought of, hold on, did they just cut out a whole scene and just not put it in the movie? Is that what happened? I think that's what happened. Because no one, it's just such a sudden end. It's a sudden and jarring end that it honestly, it feels like a scene got left on the cutting floor. And it's just such an awkward place to end the movie. And the thing that made it worse was like, that's how I was left. I was left with this feeling of, I didn't see this entire film. I didn't see everything this movie was supposed to give me. There's no way I could have, because that's not how movies end. How movies end. They don't end in the middle of the action. They end after the action. And this one just drops in the middle of the action. And it's so jarring, and I left walking away like there has to be more. I'm not sure if I want more, but there has to be more. There has to be. And I'm frustrated about it. But other than that, I don't have anything more to add to the movie. I'm trying to think about all the movies we saw this month, but I would definitely give this movie the movie of the month award. I think it was just the best one that left me thinking, left me wanting more, left me like, wait, I need to think about what I just saw. I feel like it's definitely the best movie to do that this month. Oh wait, no. Going in Style. Going in Style was the other movie I saw that month. Logan was last month. Yeah, so definitely this movie was the movie of the month. I'm gonna give that up. And so yeah. If you guys saw The Circle, I wanna know what you guys thought. I wanna know how you guys felt about it. And I also want to know if you thought I was full of garbage and I'm praising a movie way too much. But other than that, I have nothing else to add. Thank you guys for watching. My name is Insane Raven, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye-bye.